Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a 2020 motivational video. I wrote down some things that I feel like I've learned this year that I kind of want to take with me to 2020. I want this video to be like motivation for 2020. I don't want this to be a get healthy quick, lose weight fast type of video. I want it to be more of like a let's have overall happiness for 2020. I feel like that's going to be the theme of 2020. I'm sick of letting my emotions get the best of me or letting people get the best of me, and I want 2020 to just be like the year of happiness for me. And I've read a lot of like psychology books this year. In the previous 10 years, I've learned a lot about emotions and the brain and the mind. And these are 10 things that I kind of came up with for myself that I feel like I want to bring with me to 2020, and I hope will give you some motivation. So I'm gonna go ahead and dive right in. The first advice that I have going into 2020 is going to be to chase relationships and experiences over materialism. I feel like today's society is, I think honestly though, in all reality, society all the time has always been about materialism and things that bring monetary gratification and short-term gratification with that. I think we chase things that at the end of the day won't really matter. Things that are materialistic, I think, are great to have. I mean, who doesn't want to have a big house, a big car, lots of money, and fancy clothes, and all this other stuff? I think those can definitely bring happiness short term, and it brings instant gratification, but it doesn't bring long term gratification. Something that I understood is that we don't have to get rid of all those things, and we can still want those things. It's not a bad thing to want materialistic things or strive for materialistic things, but see them for face value. Know that this isn't going to bring long term happiness. Your life doesn't revolve around these materialistic things. They make your life a little bit better, but that's not what we should be chasing for. What we should be chasing for is our relationships with people, relationships with the planet, also experiences. I think at the end of the day, when we're on our deathbed, we are not gonna be like, oh damn, I wish I bought that Ferrari. Like, that's my biggest regret. It's gonna be like, you know, I wish I drove and did more road trips with my family and like got to have time with them and experience nature, you know? Like, it's not gonna be anything materialistic. So stop chasing materialism, chase experiences and relationships. I'm 25, I'm still very young, but the older that I get, the more I realize how much we really do need people. We are social creatures. One of the longest studies ever done in terms of happiness, I'll leave it down below if you guys want to read about it, it's super interesting. But basically they found that the key thing for happiness and overall longevity in terms of happiness is our relationships that we build, and not the amount of relationships, but the quality of the relationships that we have. So with 2020, let's stop with the materialism and focus more on the relationships and the experiences that we bring one another, especially here on YouTube. I feel like YouTube is just like materialistic heaven. I mean, I feel like there's so many trends right now that are going on, shoving money and how much money they spend and materialistic items that don't really matter. Be careful with what you're kind of putting your energy and time into and giving your attention to as well. The second piece of advice is to let go of resistance. I feel like when we hold on to things for so long, or we hold on to what we think they should be or what we wanted them to be or past experiences, it comes with a lot of sadness and overwhelm and anxiety and uncomfortability. Life is a whole lot more simple and easier when you let go of trying to control, manipulate situations or things or people. Something again that I've learned over the past few years is that everything is always and constantly changing. The only thing that you have guaranteed in life is yourself. We have to learn that when we're in a moment or we have certain people in our lives or certain things in our lives, that may not always be the case. And instead of looking at it in a negative way and being fearful of like when things are going to change or when things are going to go kind of out of whack, sit down and appreciate the moment for what it is, because one day you might not have what you have in front of you right now. So you need to learn to appreciate the moment and learn to appreciate things as they are. That way, when things do start to change, you're not holding on to something that you didn't appreciate in the moment. Something that I came across this year was a quote. I don't know it verbatim, but basically it was stating that it's not the action itself that makes the situation miserable, but it's the resistance to it. For example, a very common one is working out. Sitting there and thinking about, oh my god, I have to work out after work. I don't want to be here right now. I want to go watch my show. I'm thinking about dinner right now. I'm starving. Like, whatever the case is, it's not the actual physical action of working out that's making you miserable. It's the resistance to the action itself that's making you miserable in the first place. So let go of that resistance and just let life flow, because that kind of can correlate to anything in life. That could be through a huge change that you're going through right now, and maybe it's not the change itself that's making you miserable, but the way that you're thinking about it and trying to hold on to something or hold on to an idea or a concept that's making it more miserable than it needs to be. So let it go, let life work its little magic, let life flow, as corny as that sounds, and when you allow it to be as it is and stop trying to resist and control and manipulate the situations, the more you look at them differently and you can learn to appreciate it rather than resist it or be fearful of it, and you just learn to go with the flow, it's so much easier, you experience life much better and a better mindset, and it's just better overall. And something here to also keep in mind is that if things are changing in a way that you might not want it to be changing, life is crazy and it's insane that everything is actually working towards you and not against you, and you'll realize that one day. Like, I was in Orlando this past weekend and I wanted this particular life really bad 4 or 5 years ago, and I just wanted it so bad, and I was so angry at the fact that I couldn't make my life the way that I wanted to back then. But if I look at myself now compared to what I wanted then, and if I did get what I wanted, I would not be as happy, I don't think, as I am right now. And I wouldn't be as successful as I am right now. One day it will all come into full circle and you'll sit back and you'll be like, holy crap, thank God life didn't let me have what I want back then, because I am so much more happier now. And you'll realize it one day, but you can't resist it as it's happening. You gotta just let it go and just trust the process. And one day you'll look back and be like, holy crap, like, thank God, you know? The third tip that I have is to learn to appreciate and understand all of your emotions, because they all serve a vital purpose, believe it or not. A lot of the times, in terms of resistance, when you resist your emotions, the more that it's gonna overwhelm you. If you're resisting sadness, for example, and you're feeling guilty or upset or feeling that you shouldn't feel these certain feelings, and you're trying to shove them down instead of just feel them and try to understand why you're having these certain emotions, the more that it's gonna like grow inside of you. You're pushing it down, it's just gonna all bottle up. And I think that's sometimes what society tells us to do, is like certain emotions we're not supposed to have, or like you're supposed to be taking one emotion, happiness, and live with that throughout the rest of your life, and only that emotion. And if you slip up, that's not a good thing. Like, we're supposed to be happy 100% of the time, and that's not how our brain works. We have different emotions that serve a purpose, and when you learn to understand that, you let each emotion come up as they should, and you can learn to work with what emotion you're feeling at the time instead of feeling guilty for having it or striving for one certain emotion for the rest of your life forever. And I have a whole separate video about this, so I'll pop it on the screen if you guys are interested, where I get like super into it. If you guys also like movies, there's a cartoon that's called, I think it's called Inside Out by Pixar. It's a kid movie, it's a cartoon, but it is basically what that video that I made was about. And it just helps you understand each of your emotions and like the purpose behind it and all that stuff. And a lot of the emotions we wouldn't have without the other. For example, we sometimes don't look at sadness as like an emotion that we want to have, but without sadness, we would never have happiness. Happiness wouldn't exist. Without one, there wouldn't be the others. And I feel like sadness is actually very important in terms of building relationships and bonding with people, because when we're sad, we tend to kind of need each other and appreciate each other. And when happiness happens, we know that sadness happens, so we learn to appreciate the happiness and be present. And when sadness is happening, we know that happiness is out there somewhere and it'll happen again, if that makes sense. Like, there's just like this whole process. Just watch the video if you guys are into that. But just learn to appreciate and accept all the emotions for what they are. The fourth tip that I have actually came from my boyfriend, Noah. I called him one day, like, I just got really anxious and worried, and I was like, what if this happens, and what if this happens, and oh my God, I'm getting stressed and overwhelmed, like, what if this happens? And he literally looked at me, he was like, babe, there's no such thing as what if. It doesn't exist. It's not a thing. You're making it a thing by thinking about it, but it hasn't happened, so why are you acting as if it's existent? Like, what if is not even here. Like, there's no such thing as what if. I was like, oh my God, my mind like blown. And you know, it's really true. What ifs don't exist. So why do we act as if they do and overwhelm ourselves and ruin what is happening with our what ifs? And what if we looked at our what ifs positively instead of negatively? What if I go do my speech and I fumble and I forget my words? But what if we think, what if I kill that speech and like the professor notices and I get like an A+, and he comes up to me after and says, oh my god, that was amazing, do you want to do a TED talk? Like, you know, like what if we think about it as the best possible scenario? Even that, it's just, it doesn't exist, you know? So when you catch yourself thinking about what if, just remember that it doesn't exist. It simply doesn't, and it just makes it so much better. The fifth advice that I have in terms of 2020 is to be the person that you want other people to be to you. If you are constantly negative, if you are constantly putting people down, do you want other people to be like that to you? How do you want your dad to be towards you? Why don't you be more like that towards him? Because life is a reflection. What you give out, you're gonna receive. If you're negative and mean and angry all the time, that's what you're gonna receive back. And you have to really self-evaluate yourself and do some self-reflection and find out, how am I towards other people? How am I acting towards my friends? How am I acting towards my mother? How am I acting towards my significant other? What do you want in reciprocation? How do you want people to be to you, and how are you gonna show that in order to receive it? If you're driving and you find someone trying to merge into your lane, if you were in that scenario, would you want someone to let you through, or would you want someone to speed up, flick you off, and be a grump and just be a negative energy in your space? Be a person that you want to see in others be to you. Simple as that. The sixth advice that I have is to keep pushing. I think something that I've realized in terms of patience this year is that some things require a ton of trial and error. You're not gonna get things done the first time perfectly. And some things require more trial and error in order to understand it. And you have to remember that the more that you try it, the more you fail, the more you learn. If you're getting frustrated with yourself because you can't seem to grasp a concept or understand something, you gotta learn to keep going, because eventually, one day, you're gonna get there and you're gonna understand it, and it all requires a lot of trial and error. And sometimes that's just life. You just have to keep on trying and eventually you'll understand it. The seventh thing that I learned this year is to keep pushing yourself out of your comfort zone. I try every single day to do something that scares me a little bit, or do something that I'm kind of resistant towards. For example, like that little voice inside your head, it could be super small, but like let's say that you like the cash register's necklace and you're maybe too afraid to speak up and be like, oh, I really like your necklace. And that voice inside your head's like, that's weird, like don't do that. Like that little voice inside your head is a sign to like do it. So you're like, oh, cute necklace. Or like let's say you see a cute girl on the street and you're like, she's really pretty, but like something's telling you, oh, I'm kind of nervous, or like that comes off as creepy. And that little voice that's telling you not to do it, but like you have like some sort of gut or like urge to do it, go up to her and be like, oh, you're very beautiful, like I just thought you should know that. You know, when I'm in yoga, I tend to not push myself sometimes to do certain things because I'm afraid to fall. So sometimes my instructor will say, like, if you want to move your mat over to the side to do a headstand, you can do that. Sometimes I'm like, oh no, that's weird, like I don't want like everyone to like notice me doing a headstand, or like what if I fall. Like that little voice, guess what, ding ding ding, that's a sign to do the thing that you're afraid of. Every time that I've ever done this, I've always felt so much better. I felt so much more confident, and I'm less afraid next time it happens. The more that you're afraid to do something and the more that you push yourself into that situation, first of all, familiar it becomes, so you're less afraid of it next time, and the more that you understand it, you just grow in confidence. The eighth tip that I have is enough with the black and white thinking. I'm a huge black and white thinker. Black and white thinking is basically all of this or all of that, yes or no, there's no in between, no gray, basically all or nothing. And I see this a lot in society in terms of diet. So an extreme black and white thinker for diet would be cutting out food groups forever and eternity, or doing like juice cleanses, and like just being extremists, especially on social media. It's a lot of extremism. Life is about balance, you know? I'm not big into the black and white thinking because it is so bad for your mentality to think like that. And like, it's either you succeed or you fail, you know? Cutting out huge food groups for a lifestyle is not realistic. When you think black and white, you think very like perfectionist, and that's not healthy. Another way of thinking like that is to work out every single day, or doing habit trackers and having all these things that you have to do every single day. Again, it's balance. Like some days you go work out, some days you need rest, some days you want to be super productive, but that one day that you don't knock off something on your habit tracker, you freak out, like you're a failure, like, and it's just exhausting to think like that. And you see it all on YouTube now. It's insane. And it's very easy to kind of get like into that world of perfectionism and working out every day and being super healthy and living your life the most perfect way, and it's just like not realistic, and it's so fucking exhausting. I've definitely caught myself in situations like that before, and I've learned this year to just live your life in a balanced way. Stop being a black and white thinker. Don't think all in or all out. It's just a little bit of everything, you know? There's so much more less pressure when you think like that, and you have so much more happiness. Life isn't perfect. What you see online spread out to you is not realistic. It's not your reality. It's a filtered reality. And when you start looking at your life as your reality and not comparing it to that filtered reality that you see online, and you live your life in a balanced way, not an extreme perfectionist type of way that you see plastered all over the media, the more happy you become, and it's so much less stressful, and you just feel so much better. Trust me, from experience. The ninth thing is to live for yourself and not for others. So I see, again, online, a lot of people flaunting relationships, flaunting children, flaunting friendships and friend groups, and I think all of that is great. Like I said in the first tip, it's all about relationships and connections that you build. I think it's super important, but I think a lot of the times people get in this weird mindset where they live their life for other people or for other things, and when those things start to shift or change or they're no longer in your life anymore, you kind of freak out because you put all your eggs in that one basket and you don't know even who you are alone. You have to be your own person. I think relationships are very beneficial to you. They add a lot of good into your life. It's a great part of who you are, but it's not who you are. You are not your relationship. You are not your children. You are not your friendship group. You are your own person. I mean, we came into this life alone and we will leave alone. And if you're not happy with who you are and you're living your life based around somebody else or something else, you're gonna be devastated when it starts changing or it's gone. I see this a lot in like mothers. I think being a mother is like extremely, to me, I was raised by like the most amazing mother ever, and I think mothers are just like the best thing ever. But when you live your life based around what I see a lot of the times, especially in my community, is a lot of these moms live their life based around their family and their children, but then once they grow up and they leave the nest, they really kind of are left with nothing. And to me, you are so much more than your children. I think your children are who you are, definitely to a core, and they should be your main priority, and obviously like they're your life, but it's also your life, you know? Like, you gotta show yourself love, you gotta do what makes you happy, have a passion project, be okay with that. If those things were to go away one day, you wouldn't be completely devastated, and you're happy with who you are and where you are in life. I tend to do this in terms of my relationships. My relationships with people are extremely important to me, but I've noticed over the past few years, and starting even YouTube, is that I was afraid of being alone, and the sense of not having my people. I didn't even know who I was really without them. Now that I spend alone time, I still appreciate those relationships and they still mean everything to me, but I no longer am dependent on those relationships to be myself. I'm also myself without those relationships, and I'm happy with both. Does that make sense? I really hope that made sense and came through in the right way. And the 10th and final tip that I have for you guys is to focus your goals and your New Year's resolutions by month. I've been doing this and it's helped so much. If you guys watch like my Plan With Me videos, you'll probably understand this a little bit more than if you don't, but designate a theme for each month and work that way rather than throwing all of your resolutions on January 1st and going freaking crazy mentally and feeling like a failure if you don't do it 100% of the time. If you do them all at once, especially if you're not doing them on December 31st and then you just bombard yourself with these New Year's resolutions, no offense, you're probably gonna fail. Break it up by month. For example, it takes 21 days to break or make a habit, and that's like perfect in terms of months because months are like 30 to 31 days, so perfect. Let's say January, let's focus on one goal at a time. So January is going to be the month to start incorporating working out. Focus that whole month on putting working out into your schedule. By the time February comes, it'll just become a habit. Okay, now February's come, let's try to quit smoking. So for the month of February, your whole goal is to quit smoking, but you're also working out because January, you've already created a habit. March comes, you quit smoking, you started working out, now what's the next goal? You see what I'm saying here? And I started doing this and it's helped tremendously in terms of like my work. I designate my months like that as well and kind of have a theme, and it's just helped me not only knock my goals out, but stick to them as well in a realistic way and not feel so overwhelmed. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys have a tremendous 2020. I feel like this is gonna be a big year. You know, it's a whole new decade. It just feels good. It rolls off the tongue. 2020. I guess I say 2020 or 2020. I think it's gonna be 2020. But we say like 2019. Sometimes we say 2019. I don't know. But yeah, all things aside, I really hope you guys enjoy the rest of your holiday. If you guys are new to my channel, definitely subscribe if you want to see some holiday content. I have like this whole holiday schedule planned. Every Monday we're doing vlogs. Every Tuesday we're doing holiday themes. Every Wednesday is going to be New Year content like this. Every Thursday is going to be more holiday content. And then every Friday is going to be another vlog. So if you guys aren't subscribers and you guys are just here for this video, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the rest of your holiday. And for everyone that are subscribers, I'll see you guys all in a future video. Bye, guys.
Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging. Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging.